I just remember there being an awful lot of bands on that show that were kind of all starting out at the same time.
Van Halen, okay, 1978. Van Halen was on our tour that year.
Believe It or Not was a new band to a lot of people at that time.
I was very close to the guys at Van Halen because we were in the studio together.
Van Halen had their first single, Running With the Devil.
These guys are ornery.
And we took them out on the first tour.
Alex Van Halen is ornery.
Did they break us in or did we break them in?
It was more the other way.
Yeah.
Eddie's ornery.
They were on this rampage back in those days of like busting up hotel rooms and throwing TVs out in the swimming pool.
Michael Anthony, he's a sweetie. He's sweet.
I was maybe 8 years old. The doctors said I was hyperactive. And they told my parents, oh, we have to put Dave on Ritalin therapy and all of this, because every night at dinner when I get the blood sugars up, I'd start ticky-tacking with the knives and forks on the table, and I'd start telling jokes and singing commercials from television and everything. And the folks would say to the company, now don't worry about David, he's just doing what we call monkey hour. And I have successfully turned monkey hour into a career.
I'd say 90% of that crowd that day didn't know what they looked like, if you can believe that. They had no clue.
I remember when Van Halen come walking down the ramp, and it was my first introduction to hair bands, you know? I mean, I was sitting there going, it was quite a shock, you know, seeing these guys come in with makeup on and their hair all frizzed out and spandex. I hadn't seen that before. We were still all rock and rollers in blue jeans. And
this long, blonde-haired guy just came out on stage, you know, like, with his arms up and like he owned the place, and pretty much just all at once the whole crowd stood on his feet. Eddie Van Halen jumped to his knees and started the beginning of the instrumental solo he does called Eruption. And I swear that was the highlight of the entire afternoon.
Listen to all these bands. It says Aerosmith, Ted Nugent, Atlanta Rhythm Section, Head East, Heart, Frank Marino, Mahogany Rush, Eddie Money, Van Halen, Walter Egan. I don't even know who he is. Journey. Was he really there that day?